Well, after the Maui fires, there's a lot of hazardous debris all over the area and may take months to clean it up. We wanted to know how dangerous those materials could be if they went into the ocean. So, Dr. Robert Richmond, who's a research professor, he's been with us before. He's joining us this morning to find out. So, good morning, Dr. Richmond. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Oh, thanks very much for the invitation.
Yeah, so I thought about it. I mean, we want rain. We really need rain. We got some pretty bad drought out there, obviously fire hazards, but we're not expecting any significant rain for a while. Obviously, that's bad because it's dry, but is that a good thing right now that we're not getting any rain for Lahaina and the ocean area there?
Yeah, the best combination would be a very light rain to keep the dust down and the particles, because that's one way things get into the ocean. But yeah, right now a large rainstorm would be really problematic because of all the areas have been burned out. There's kind of a rogues gallery of toxicants that are there. Everything, there's a particular chemical that's associated with burning, benzoate pyrene, which is really bad for any living creature, including corals and fish. There's heavy metals from the copper wire, there's asbestos, there's a lot of things out there, hydrocarbons. And so really want to keep this out of the ocean. And so, you know, the perfect combination right now would be a little bit of rain to tamp down the dust, not enough to push anything into the ocean, and a good swell coming from that side to flush things out. That would be like the perfect karma and what people should hope for.
Yeah. So, well, tell me, Dr. Richmond, what if we had a heavy rain today over Lahaina? What would happen to all that stuff?
Yeah, most of it would end up in the ocean. Storm drainage systems and just sheet runoff. On the ground cover that was lost, all of the other coverage that collects material and distributes it more evenly are gone. And so we've seen this in fires on the mainland, and that's, you know, this is not unique to Maui, but throughout California, Canada, any place where there's been devastating wildfires like the one that hit Lahaina is going to cause a loss of protective cover. And then the next major rain that comes, you'll get all kinds of materials going to the ocean. In addition to the usual sediment and pollutants that are there, we have this whole new range of toxicants associated with the fire that are fairly localized and are a real concern.
So I read, it was just a few days after, I think, the fires, that the Coast Guard has taken actions to kind of stop this from spreading in the ocean. What actions have they taken since then, or totally what have they taken to avoid hazardous materials going into the ocean?
Yeah, I was on a call yesterday with several state officials and people from Maui, the Maui Nui Marine Resource Council, and it was very encouraging for me, and I think people need to know. The state and federal governments have really stepped up to be able to address the issue now. Right now, the best thing you want to do is the prevention phase. You know, this terrible tragedy happened. People are still reeling from it, and there's the recovery of people, lives, things lost. But for the environment, this is the opportunity to move forward. FEMA and NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, have been working together to be able to access funds for emergency response. Jerry Davis, the Assistant Administrator for the Pacific Islands Regional Office at NOAA here in Hawaii, has been working with both the state and federal agencies, and they're moving up. Yesterday, I was speaking with some of the people from Hawaii's State Division of Aquatic Resources, Russell Sparks on Maui, Ryan O'Connor here on Oahu. They're coordinating activities on everything from the kinds of things, putting out sediment socks. We could talk about that in a moment, but these are very good barriers to try to keep materials out. They're working on water sampling to find out what's out there. There's coordination efforts going on from various groups in the community. Funding will be available, and hopefully this will create jobs for some of the people who lost the jobs to be involved in activities to help prevent further damage to the coastal communities, coral reefs, and fisheries. And it's a way of healing not only the environment, but I think for the communities that are suffering as a result of it, that can also start the healing process.
Yeah, it's also a good experience in case we have some kind of a chemical spill or fuel spill somewhere else that might affect the oceans. People would know how to do it. But thank you very much. It's glad to see. I'm glad to hear that everybody has taken action to prevent this on top of everything else. The last thing we want to do is pollute the ocean. Dr. Richmond, thank you for joining us again.
Thanks again for the opportunity.